Hey guys, Brooke Walker here, 7 weeks out from the Olympia. Today's another leg day. I hope you guys enjoyed our last video. It was super, super festive. Somebody said something about like a Subway sandwich. I was a taco. It was not a Subway sandwich, it was a taco. But it actually wasn't hard to work out in. The taco did kind of get in my face, but you know what? It makes it fun, right? So anyway, 7 weeks out from the Olympia and we're hitting legs today. I've got Lexi and Melissa with us and you know, I'm super grateful for them because obviously at this point I start to get tired, you know, my energy starts to kind of get drained. So having somebody there with you to kind of help push you and motivate you through those last workouts, it's really encouraging and it makes a huge difference. So today we'll kind of keep it somewhat basic. I won't go too crazy on weights, but I'm gonna push it. I actually had somebody message me about doing some glute work. So, you know, if you guys have been kind of following along, I don't ever necessarily do a glute specific day. I kind of just do two traditional leg days. One is not necessarily quad based or glute based. However, you can obviously do that if you want. Some people will do quad focus day, some will do glute hamstrings. Those are all fine. There's so many different splits. However, I just like to stick to two traditional leg days. But today, for you, I am going to do a little bit of the glute stuff. The butt stuff, I don't know if that's appropriate to say, but it is, right? So we're gonna keep it fun, keep it interesting, and I hope you guys enjoy it.
Thank you. Rookie.
The first two, I was like, you made a mistake.
No mistakes. No mistakes. No. That made it look effortless.
Love that. So we're hitting legs, we're doing a little butt stuff, right? So we kind of started off, warmed up with some light lunges, barbell lunges, then we increased the weight from there. We did a sumo stance, kind of stiff leg deadlift, which I like personally because I'm able to kind of feel it in my glutes, my hamstrings, and I just overall get a better feel for it. Some people will obviously do more of a narrow stance, completely fine. I think a lot of times people go super, super heavy on any of their stiff leg deadlifts, and you know, obviously the goal is to push yourself, but you don't want to sacrifice other muscle groups in the process of trying to target one specific muscle group when you start to lose form, right? And I think a lot of people do that in regards to that particular exercise. So we challenged ourselves, it was tough, but we also made sure that we kept our form and didn't sacrifice it. We are now moving on to the glute drive machine, or if you don't have access to a glute drive machine, you could use like a barbell hip thrust in place of that. We're keeping our reps relatively high at 15, just keeping every movement nice and slow, controlled, focusing on the squeeze at the top. You know, as I tell everybody, squeeze the cheeks at the top and create that granny butt. You guys know what I'm talking about when I say that. So, glute drive, building the glutes, right? Legs off of the power squat. You could, if you don't have access to that machine, you could do like a barbell step up or a dumbbell step up. It kind of mimics the same movement. However, on that power squat, I like it because it puts you at a, just a little bit of a different angle. So you're able to target your glutes and your hamstrings a little bit better. You know, that exercise is really, really tough. So if you do have access to that machine, I encourage you to try it. Start off light, because I assure you, it's a lot more challenging than you would think. So we kept our reps at about 15 each leg, increase the weight if possible, and now we're gonna kind of move on. You know, usually if you guys are kind of following along, I like to run the line, and the way our gym is set up, we kind of have our adductor, abductor machines, our leg extensions, leg curls, all in a line. And whenever I'm warming up, I like to typically use those machines to get warmed up. They were all full today. Today's like everybody's leg day, so we didn't warm up there today, so now we're gonna kind of finish there, and we are going to move on to yet another 2-minute drill. So if you guys are following along with those 2-minute drills, you know we like them. Today we're gonna do a little glute base abductor 2-minute drill. So There's more. Such a photo of that.
Yes.
Here, go sit butt pump.
It better be super pump.
We conquered, you know? Alright guys, so you know the drill. We just finished up with a 2-minute drill, obviously. So we did some abduction work. What we did is we used a little glute band or booty band. We placed the band mid-calf, and we did kind of our 2-minute sequence, but we isolated each leg, right? So we did 2 minutes per leg before we switch, right? So we did pause reps, right, 20 seconds, and then we eliminated that pause and just went for tempo for 20. We alternated that sequence for 2 minutes nonstop. Then we switch sides and we perform the same exact concept on the other leg. Obviously, it makes it a bit more challenging with the band. So if you're not to that point yet, you can do it body weight without any added band or any added resistance. And it is surprisingly challenging. Make sure you keep your toe up, foot stays flexed, right? A lot of times people will kind of almost kick back out to the side. You want to make sure that you're kicking straight out, side to side. You don't want to lean, you don't want to lean back, right? Stay completely upright. Keep constant tension on your legs, right? So you should feel it, your glutes, your hips, all the things. You want an immediate butt pump, you're gonna get it. So try it out. Let me know what you guys think.